Hey everybody, excuse my voice. I'm getting over a little summer cold. If you're interested in this unit that I'm wearing, it is by the wig company and the name is New Daisy, and I'll leave the information card right up here. Today, we're going to do an experiment, and I don't know how it's going to turn out, but it's just an idea that I have. I could not get my hands on that Halo Stitch wig by Outre, the 14-inch one, or the other one. I forget how long it was, but and it was a little pricey. The 14-inch was like $50, and I'll leave a picture right here just to refresh your memory. So anyway, I got this braid, and it's by Vivica Fox, and I got it from Ebony Line. It was $9.95, and I saw it on Tia Maria's channel. Shout out to Tia Maria. Hey girl, hey. And so I got it in a number two, and this is how it looks on the stock card. And this is how the actual braid looks. And I saw this wig by Outre called 3B Rhythm Ringlets. And it looks like it's about the same hair texture as the Halo Stitch wig. So I was like, well, maybe I can make my own Halo Stitch wig. And I got this from Ebony Line as well. It was $30.95. So $30.95 and $10. We're at $40. We're only saving $10 plus we gotta put in the work, but you know, sometimes we just gotta do what we gotta do and improvise and make it work. And it feels really, really thick. And it has the little wispy hairs, baby hairs, whatever you wanna call them. And I got this in a number two as well. So hopefully it'll match. And this is the wig. And that's the texture of it. It has the brown lace. There's the parting space. And it's the typical cap construction with the two cones at the temples or the sides. It's parted down the middle. And you have the breathable cap and the comb in the back. With the adjustable straight bands. So I don't know if I'm gonna be able to braid this across here. It has the smaller braid across here, and then it has this bigger braid that kind of goes across the top of the head. So let me cut the lace off and I'll come back and let you all know what I came up with. So you all, I have a confession to make. I am a full-fledged 100% card-carrying member of the Black Girl Can't Braid Club. And so I ended up doing some twists, which I'm not even really good at that. And this is what I came up with. It's cute, but I think it could look better. And I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my next door neighbor to put the braids around here for me. And but other than that, I think it's cute. And I think that it turned out pretty close to what that Halo Stitch wig looks like. So, and it's very full. I really like it. It's really kind of giving me the Afrocentric vibes. And so here's how it is all the way around. And it's a lot of hair, but it is not heavy. And I think it's cute. I really, really do like it. It's just, and it had wispy hairs and I put them down right here. It has some more on the sides, but I think I cut them off when I cut the lace off, and then I just put my hair fetish in the part to make it more pronounced. And so yeah, and the wig, I don't think it's big head friendly. My head is 21¼, and it fits my head kind of to the T. And matter of fact, I don't even think the ear tabs come all the way down. So it's not gonna be big head friendly at all, but you could probably get away with it because it is a lot of hair, and just kind of let it cover up the sides a little bit. But yeah, overall, I think it's cute, and you know, just some big hoop earrings and all of that. Yeah, I think I did okay. I think I did 75%, not 100%. Maybe an 80% so I can get a B. But you all let me know what you think. And I hope you like it. And thank you for stopping by, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.